Welcome back to the adventure. Today we're talking about what web browser is best for Windows Vista in 2020 and beyond. As we discussed in the previous video for Windows XP, there are many browsers that can be installed, but only some of them are able to load modern websites. The reason for this is Secure Socket Layer, SSL, and Transport Layer Security, TLS. These are web standards for how data is transported and encrypted. In August of 2018, TLS version 1.3 was introduced. Since March of 2020, most major browsers discontinued support for TLS 1.0 and 1.1. This means that long-term, we want a browser for Windows Vista that supports TLS 1.3, if any exist. Once we narrow down the options based on the browser's ability to render web pages, we want to test each browser for TLS 1.3 support. Modern websites use HTML5 and CSS3, so we can eliminate more browsers that lack sufficient support for these standards, leaving us with our best options for the foreseeable future. Some of the browsers here do not support TLS 1.2, so we can cross those off the list straight away. Internet Explorer, Netscape Navigator, Opera, Safari, and SeaMonkey, all gone. Time to toss the rest of these browsers into groups based on their engine. There we go. Google's Chromium, Mozilla's Gecko, Apple's WebKit, and Microsoft's Trident. Whenever the video on browser engines is available, a card will appear right about here. For the first test, we will look at HTML5 support. Open a browser and type html5test.com in the address bar. At the top of the page is a banner with a score out of a possible 555 points. As we scroll down the page, we will have a list of test results and how the browser performed. We can record the results and continue to the next browser. I'm going to test all of these browsers for posterity. Here is a breakdown of all the scores. We can eliminate the browsers that scored less than 300. Avant, Midori, and Lunascape are now gone. For the next test, we are looking at the browser's security. Open a browser, and in the address bar, type browseraudit.com. Click the Test Me button at the bottom of the page. The test will begin and can take several minutes to complete. At the end of the test, we can expand the Test Details section of the page and see the results for each item. We can record the overall score and move on to the next browser. Now to look at the browser's ability to render web pages. Open a browser and type acidtests.org in the address bar and press Enter. From this page, select the ACID3 test. When the test completes, we should have a screen that looks like the reference rendering, viewable by clicking the link at the bottom of the page. As we observed before, several browsers fail this test in different ways. Here is a breakdown of the results from the ACID test. We still have 24 browsers here that are perfectly fine to use right now. We need to look towards the future for browsers that support TLS 1.3. Open one of the browsers. I'm going to start with Advanced Chrome and type browserleaks.com/SSL in the address bar. This page gives us all kinds of valuable information on security and encryption standards the browsers support. The one we are focused on right now is TLS 1.3. We just need to keep testing each browser to see if any of them happen to support it. Things are really not looking so good. I'm positive that at least one of the browsers has support for TLS 1.3. Here is a breakdown of the results. If we clear out all the browsers that do not support TLS 1.3, we are left with New Moon, Cupzilla, and Otter Browser. Of these browsers, I recommend New Moon. I received quite a bit of criticism on the last video that I did not make it clear which browser was best for XP. So here it is, the winner of the Best Browser for Windows Vista award goes to New Moon. If you are interested in the download links for the mini browser shown here today, click on the forum post on MSFN. I have a video up on WinClient5270's channel talking more about the forum post and what can be found there. All relevant links will be in the description. Just like last time, there will be some additional footage of the browser tests after the outro. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.